Have you tried Jonas Brothers?
Not yet.
Not yet?
Oh, I wouldn't do it. Just stay away.
Oh my god!
Thank you.
Y'all have been playing music together for quite a while, I feel like.
A couple of years, 3 years.
You've not been in Some Surprises since the beginning.
Not since the beginning.
Right. It's been y'all, mainly. So how did... Let's pair y'all together. How did y'all get started with the project? Where did it... Who was the birther of it all?
Well, I started as a solo project maybe, like, 6 or 7 years ago. And then I had, like, a noise trio. So I played with Dustin Williams and mm-hmm. Sam Henry, who's... Plastic Boner Band is his noise project.
Sick.
But
made by Mattel.
And they would kind of just like wash over me with a lot of noise, and it was a cool addition of the project. I think we played with Jesse and Gray Waves, Dan, Jesse and Dan who live here, and Brandon at a weird venue in Tacoma that looks like a teapot.
After that, you basically were like, I am tired of being drowned out by them. I'll just drown out myself.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's a good way to put it.
Yeah.
I wanted, like, a full band sound, so I didn't have a drummer or anything. I just started writing new songs and then sort of, like, one by one collected a band together. And mm-hmm. was really lucky to meet these guys. So.
How did y'all link up in the beginning? How did Craigslist ad... best friends from junior high.
I saw the old Some Surprises, and then we played a show together in a different. I was in a different band. Some Surprises was a different band.
We became
the same band.
We were trying to set up a show in Anacortes with Carl Blau. That didn't
work out.
And then we ended up playing with Circuit de U at the Lo-Fi, and then just started playing together after that.
Lyrically, it seems like it's treated more as an instrument than it is a pay attention to what the fuck I'm saying. Do you usually write it like melody first? Do you come with lines? Do you already have like what you want to say set up and then just put it into place? Or is it just like creating a melody while you're playing guitar?
Usually while I'm playing. I would say we have a full-length record coming out where the vocals are a lot more clear, mm-hmm. I think. They're definitely not, like, dry and, you know, front and center. It is, like, part of the other music that's going on. And yeah, they're kind of, like, depersonalized lyrics that can be more universal. And
sure.
Things like that. So I feel like lyrics are only important if they're bad, you know.
They're only important if they're bad.
Yeah. Because if they're, you know, if you don't notice how bad they are, they're pretty good.
Oh, yeah, I guess that's a good point. Yeah. If you're like, oh my god, those suck. You're like, I'm getting okay with that.
Thank you. Magic!
Let's see some
magic! Magic, my dear friends! That's why we're here tonight. My first trick, I'm gonna make this egg a very popular trending item these days. Disappear, because it's ruining my feed. However, before I came here, there was some questions about if I was using legitimate eggs, so I just wanted to prove we are, in fact, using real eggs.
Wow, indeed. Okay.
So, trick number one. Let's make this egg disappear, you guys. We got this, it's totally fine. Okay. Can't actually make eggs disappear. So, I knew one trick was gonna bomb. Thank God it was the first one, right? We've got two more to kind of work our way through. For this next trick, what I'd like to do for all of you, let's take these beautiful porcelain plates. I've been working out. Sorry, my abs hurt bending over. But one does, in fact, have a very, very pointy nail. And if you would like to
touch that to prove that is indeed a hard nail, does it hurt?
No, don't hurt yourself. It's rusty. So what we're going to do... good stuff. I'm gonna put these into Value Corner lunch bags. All right. So, or wait, let's see. Let's do this first. It's a memorization game, really. It's not so much magic. But what's gonna end up happening is, these beautiful porcelain plates are going to be put inside these not-so-beautiful paper bags that are indeed recyclable. So that's good news. And then we're going to shuffle them up, and then I'm gonna smash my hand on them, and we'll see what happens. Pretty scary stuff, but what I've learned is that in life, you don't take risks, you don't get rewards. Isn't that right, Christopher Byrne? All right. You're a good guest. Thank you for cooperating. All right. Okay, everybody shut the fuck up. Let's do this. I don't want to move that one quite yet. Okay, you ready for me to smash my hand on these bags? No. Let's do this for real. Let's kind of move these around. And just so you know, I'm actually looking directly at my best friend in the entire world, Dan Paulus. Yes. Ha ha ha! Chris Byrne! You just got Schroederine. All right. Do I have any volunteers? Does anybody actually want to try a bag before I go after it? Chris, do you want the first one? Yeah, baby. Let's feel that shit. We're having a great time. Ready? Ah! Should I hit this last one? Yes. No, I'm not going to. But just so you know, there's no foul play. I am the great Schroederini!
I performed magic. Do y'all have any questions for me?
Were you scared of stabbing your hand?
No, I wasn't. I left fear behind a very long time ago. There's nothing that can stand in between me and my dreams.
You ever fuck with Mountain Dew Code Red?
You know, I have been like, I wanted the training wheel into it, and I needed to remember what the original tasted like. Because I don't want to like start veering off into other stuff and then be like, well, this Mountain Dew has really changed.
Well, there's
a whole But honestly, I did buy these because, like I said, I'm into Rocket League these days. And I just wanted the full experience. So I bought a 12-pack of Mountain Dew and some donut holes. And I bought the headset. And I talked to people online and honed them, if you will. I think that's what they call it. It's pretty tight.
Did you get gamer fuel ever? Whatever.
No. Okay. So funny that you bring that up. I'm starting on the regular, and then I was gonna move into the Code Red, and then after I got used to the Code Red to see how that felt with the games, I was gonna get into gamer fuel, which is their new product of choice, and
no
it's got like
way.
A. The cool thing is it's got a grip to it, so you don't, because you know, slippery. But then also the tab somehow like closes itself back, and so I'm sitting here like, so why don't I just buy a 20-ounce bottle of anything I want, because those also close back. So I need to like, you know, that's like stage 3, so I'll get there maybe by the next episode.
Yeah.
We'll have more info.
Wow.
Yeah.
Thank you.